Broches, welcome back to my channel. I'm Julie and I'm the owner of Broche Ballet, a ballet studio for adults here in Denver, Colorado. Today I'm going to talk a little bit about your ballet slippers. I get a lot of questions about what's the best kind, what's the difference, and what's all this about, so I want to talk a little bit about that today. So here is my ballet slippers. So there's a few different variables that we're talking about here. The first is whether it's leather or canvas, and that is in relationship to all this material around the ballet slipper. The second is how the elastics are sewn, whether they're sewn crisscross like what we're seeing here, or if they're sewn with just one piece straight across. And the last one is on the bottom, whether it's a full sole where these pads go all the way across, or if it's a split sole like this. So let's start with leather or canvas. So my preference is typically canvas. This is a little bit of a personal preference. I think they breathe a little bit better for my feet, especially since my feet get a little bit sweaty and during class I like to have a more breathable shoe. But the big difference between the shoes is how they work on the floor. So if you dance a lot on wood floor, you're gonna want a shoe with more friction on the floor, and so leather is gonna be a really good fit for that. But if you dance on marley floor, like what we're looking at here, it already has that friction built into it, and so a canvas shoe can help you slide a little bit better. So a lot of it is personal preference, but then the floor choice does have a big bit to do with it as well, where if you have canvas on a wood floor, you're going to be sliding all over the place, and if you have leather on a marley floor, your pirouettes are going to be pretty sticky. But either way works, it's just a little bit of a personal preference. The second is how the elastics are shown. I'll show you on my slippers that I'm wearing. These are crisscross elastics. Sometimes you'll see one with just one bit of elastic. This is definitely personal preference. I like the look of the crisscross elastics. I think they look a little bit more ballet, a little bit fancier than just the one strip that goes straight across. But that one is definitely a bit of personal preference. Sometimes with crisscross elastics, like these shoes that I bought, they only come with one part of the elastic sewn, and so the elastics are actually hanging off the shoe when you buy them. To sew, you have to sew the elastics yourself. So in order to sew them, you're gonna put it on your foot, and you're gonna pin the elastic right in the arch of your foot, and sew right there, right underneath the drawstring to get that elastic anchored down. You can do this with a sewing machine, or you can do this with a needle and thread by hand, either way. Some of them come pre-sewn and some of them don't. The last bit is whether you want a full sole or a split sole. And again, this is a split sole, and the full sole has this pad that goes all the way down. This is also a little bit of personal preference. There's some people who say that a full sole will give your foot a better workout because as you point your foot, there's more resistance in the shoe. Personally, I haven't found that to make that big of a difference. I think you can do a lot of foot exercises and should be doing those regardless if you have full or split shoe anyways. So I haven't found that to make much of a difference. And for me, I like the split sole because they make your feet look really pointy and kind of exaggerate that arch and the point in your foot and kind of a better aesthetic there. These shoes that I'm holding right here are a Grishko shoe that actually even have a little bit of elastic between your split soles that when you point your foot really sucks the shoe up into your arch and makes the foot look even pointier. So the split sole versus full sole is a little bit debated in terms of the full sole, some people say gives you a better workout, but the split sole is a much nicer aesthetic look. So I think even regardless of which sole you have, you should be doing your foot exercises to keep your feet strong every day. So that's just a little bit about how to pick a ballet slipper, whether you want canvas, what kind of elastic, and what kind of sole you want. Let me know if you have any questions in the comments below. Don't forget to like and subscribe and click the notification bell. Until next time.